In a kingdom nestled between mist-covered mountains and rolling meadows, there lived a young princess named Isabella. Known far and wide for her breathtaking beauty and kind heart, Isabella was adored by everyone in the realm. Her father, King Ferdinand, ruled the land with wisdom and compassion, ensuring peace and prosperity for his subjects. One day, as the sun painted the sky in hues of pink and gold, a grand celebration was held in the kingdom. It was the princess's 18th birthday, a momentous occasion that marked her transition into adulthood. The entire kingdom was adorned with colorful banners and fragrant flowers, and the air was filled with joyous laughter and enchanting melodies. As the day unfolded, Isabella received lavish gifts from the courtiers, nobles, and even commoners who admired her from afar. The festivities reached their peak with a grand feast in the royal banquet hall. The hall was adorned with crystal chandeliers, and the long tables were laden with the finest delicacies. Isabella, dressed in a gown that sparkled like the stars, moved gracefully through the crowd, acknowledging the well-wishers with a radiant smile. However, amidst the revelry, a mysterious figure entered the hall unnoticed. Cloaked in shadows, a wicked sorceress named Morgana had harbored a grudge against the royal family for years. Her heart seethed with envy, for she believed that her own talents were overlooked in favor of the royal court's favored magicians. Morgana approached the throne with a malevolent grin, her eyes gleaming with dark intent. Without warning, she cast a wicked spell upon the princess. "On this joyous day, let the beauty sleep, and a slumber deep, her dreams to keep," she chanted, weaving an enchantment that enveloped Isabella in a shimmering veil of magic. As the final words left Morgana's lips, a hush fell over the hall. The once vibrant celebration turned into a scene of bewilderment and despair. Isabella, frozen in a graceful pose, succumbed to the sorceress's curse. The king, paralyzed with grief, begged Morgana to undo the spell, but she vanished into the shadows, leaving the kingdom in a state of shock. The news of Isabella's enchanted slumber spread like wildfire, reaching the farthest corners of the realm. The once thriving kingdom fell into a somber silence, with its people grieving the loss of their beloved princess. King Ferdinand, overcome with sorrow, declared that anyone who could break the curse and awaken Isabella would be handsomely rewarded. Years passed, and the kingdom lay dormant in its sorrow. The once lush meadows withered, and the vibrant colors that once adorned the kingdom faded into muted shades. Yet, in a small cottage on the outskirts of the realm, a young and humble sorcerer named Elias had been studying the ancient arts. Elias had heard tales of Isabella's enchanted slumber and felt a calling to break the curse that plagued the kingdom. Armed with a magical amulet passed down through generations, he set out on a journey to find a way to awaken the sleeping princess. His quest led him to distant lands, where he encountered wise sages and mystical creatures who guided him on his path. Elias faced numerous challenges and overcame treacherous obstacles, all fueled by the hope of restoring joy to the grieving kingdom. Finally, after years of tireless searching, Elias discovered a forgotten prophecy hidden within the dusty tomes of an ancient library. The prophecy spoke of a sorcerer with a pure heart, destined to break the curse and awaken the Sleeping Beauty. Armed with newfound knowledge, Elias returned to the kingdom with a determined spirit. The people, once resigned to their sorrow, glimpsed a spark of hope in the sorcerer's eyes. Elias stood before the castle gates, his magical amulet glowing with an ethereal light. As he approached the throne room, Elias faced the lingering darkness that Morgana's curse had left behind. The air crackled with magical energy as he chanted incantations passed down through generations. The amulet pulsed with each word, dispelling the enchantment that bound Isabella in her eternal slumber. A soft, golden light enveloped the princess, and the spell that had plagued the kingdom for so long began to unravel. Isabella stirred, her eyelids fluttering open to reveal eyes that sparkled like the morning dew. The kingdom erupted in cheers, and the once dimmed colors burst forth in a vibrant celebration. King Ferdinand, overcome with gratitude, embraced Elias, thanking him for breaking the curse and restoring his daughter to him. The people of the kingdom rejoiced, and the land, once desolate, bloomed once again with life and joy. As for Morgana, her dark deeds did not go unpunished. The magic that she had wielded with malice turned against her, and she found herself trapped in a mirror, forever reflecting on the consequences of her wicked actions. The kingdom learned a valuable lesson that day, that even in the face of the darkest curses, the pure-hearted and determined could bring forth the light of hope. Isabella, awakened from her enchanted slumber, ruled the kingdom with kindness and compassion, ensuring that the legacy of love and resilience endured for generations to come. And so, the tale of Sleeping Beauty's enchanted slumber became a story of triumph over adversity, a testament to the enduring power of love and courage.